like to begin with some introduction to the questions of magic, of magical realism. It's extremely widespread used, the term magical realism.
Has proven difficult to define. This is largely due to the fact that the term has a rich variety of applications and its meaning has been continuously changed over time. Thus, magic realism has had a rather so-called hectic career and today enjoys a more diverse usage than ever. And most of the definitions arise from or conclude to the problem of distinguishing magic realism from the so-called fantastic, usually saying that as opposed to the fantastic, where the supernatural comes out or descends or erupts into reality from an ontologically different or transcendent realm, in magic realism, the supernatural element is immanent. It can be a hidden property of reality. It can belong to a human psyche, or it can be created by the encounter between the two, but it always grows organically out of the so-called represented world. So it seems that the core of the problem is the term itself as being, or usually referred to as being an oxymoron. And the definitions had to deal with magic and realism, either contrasting them or highlighting the interconnectedness of these poles, like discussion, the amalgamation of the ordinary and the supernatural, the amalgamation of realism and fantasy. But behind these definition attempts lies the assumption that there are two different ontological realms which could be reconciled. However, there are interpretations of the term which try to break away or break with the opposition amalgamation approaches. And in my talk, I will focus on and base on the the theory of a Hungarian literary critic theoretician, Tomás Bényai, and his writings, and especially his book on magic realist novels entitled Apocryphal Writings. And Bényai stresses the so-called non-antinomy dynamics of the term. I will quote, "Every approach focusing on the presence of the supernatural implicitly assumes an epistemologically definable binarism, placing the ordinary against the supernatural, although it is exactly this assumption that magic realist texts challenge by redefining the epistemological inquiry as a rhetorical issue." So Bényai emphasizes the exposure of the real and the fantastic as rhetorical effects. And in his theory, the degree of reality for a particular object or event or character is seen as an effect produced by the narrative. So the so-called rhetorical createdness of the telling, both the story and the word, the, as he uses it, the modality of the narration, affects the story level, defining the mode of existence of objects in the narrated world as always already rhetorically conditioned. And I will quote again, "In magic realism, because of the rhetoricity and effect of both the realm and the supernatural, there is simply no degree of realism, for instance, rationalism, that could generously accommodate and naturalize the miraculous." End of quote. So, so Bényai argues that magic realist texts insert, for example, a lot of gradations or levels between these so-called poles, exaggerations, impossible events, or impossible events which are impossible but or not impossible but rather unlikely, improbable coincidences and repetitions, and that means and that is to highlight that there are or there is no single coherent code of supernatural events in magic realist mode or text, films, novels, so on. So you cannot order them into a coherent realm whose difference from the ordinary is the same in the quantitative or qualitative sense. So that means there is no reconciliation or a struggle between these two realms. And that's why Benyai says that the analysis is, should focus on the different textual and rhetorical uses rather than the so-called struggle or amalgamation theory. So in my talk here, I will explore the question of this non-antimony